If you go downtown frequently or just pop in now and again, there's a good chance that you've been stuck without enough change for the parking meter. A new pilot program is giving drivers more options when it comes to feeding the meter. WLKY's Karen Roby joins us now from the newsroom with more on the new technology. Hi, Karen.
Hi, Vicki. You know, it's a familiar sight on downtown streets. Drivers are shortchanging meters because they don't have enough cash or coins on hand. Metro officials are hoping the 90-day pilot program will make life a little bit easier for folks on both sides of the meter.
I'm just going to use cash.
David Lawless says today is an unusual one. He actually has the right amount of change on hand to pay for parking, but the ability to use plastic is a welcome sight.
Well, it's just easier. You don't always have the change to put into a meter, and you don't always have cash. You know, so a credit card would be very good.
The parking authority, the River City, is testing out 3 high-tech pay stations on 3rd and Muhammad Ali. They want to test the waters to see just how well drivers do or don't take to the fancy meters.
People are going to want to use them, if people frown to them because of new technology, if they find them more user-friendly, more convenient.
Here's how it works. Motorists pull up to a spot, find their space number on a temporary sign attached to the old meters, and make their way to the pay station. Cash, coins, smart cards, and credit cards can then be inserted. Drivers can add time if needed, and receipts are printed after every transaction.
We're hoping that they'll be well received.
The meters are on loan to the city and will record users' habits so officials can accurately measure the forms of payment most widely used. If park officials choose to purchase several meters, they will be placed in strategic locations.
Once they are, everybody in the city is acclimated with them, we won't have as many on one block. There may be one or two, depending on the length of the block.
The stations run on solar panels and are widely used in other cities across the country. Most drivers we talked with are hoping they become a permanent fixture.
It will be very easy because nobody carries cash anymore.
So far, park officials say the feedback from the public has been mainly positive. Some people have complained, however, about the machines, saying they're just too difficult to use. Each pay station costs between $7,000 and $10,000 and has the ability to service more than 100 spots. Park officials say in the end, the high-tech meters could save the city money because attendants will receive alerts to a handheld device, letting them know when cars are in violation, eliminating the need for employees to drive around to check individual meters. In the newsroom, I'm Karen Roby, WLKY News.